Part 2. The Return, 1961 to 1962. Slaves we are, and unencumbered. Best may do the master's mind. And whatever he may order, do it with a will resigned. Jami, Salman and Upsal. The Return. As the Sangat in England increased its membership, both by the initiation of British people interested in its teachings and by immigrant Indian satsangis in large numbers, the idea of a party visiting the Dera by air grew in our imagination. A few individual members had been able to put this into practice, but it was not until August 1961 that Gurchetan Singh, the sponsor of the Indian group, presented the idea of an expedition to the Dera by air during the following winter season. Having received the blessings of our present Satguru, Maharaj Charan Singh Ji, on the scheme, Gurchetan, with help from other members of the Indian group, was able to organize the visit so that we all left together on Christmas Day, but returned each one at their own convenience. Footnote: Maharaj Charan Singh passed from his physical form on June 1, 1990, after appointing the present master, Baba Gurinder Singh, as his successor. End footnote. Our party consisted of 7 British members and 30 Indians, not all of whom were initiates. The British satsangis were Mrs. Margaret Benson Cook, Mrs. Eleonora Jepp, Mrs. May Holt, Mr. Alex McCaskill, Mr. Claude Lovelace, my husband Ronald, and myself. 3 Indian members who also went were Gurchetan himself, Mr. R. Kareer, and Mr. Harmander Mohinder Ahuja. 25th December. Today, at 9:30 a.m., our party assembled at Great Cumberland Place, the Sangat's London Center, and from there we traveled by chartered coach to London Airport. Although the morning was icy, Colonel Sanders came out to wish us Godspeed, and many Indians accompanied us as far as the airport to see us away. When we arrived there, a slight mist began to form, but it soon dispersed. We took off on time, and all was well, our aircraft being a Comet 4C jet. 26th December. We had an uneventful journey, touching down at Rome just before sunset, and after dark at Cairo and Doha, arriving at Karachi by 10:35 a.m. Some hours later, having changed airlines, we proceeded to Delhi, hoping to arrive at 5 p.m. Later, after considerable delay with the customs authorities, which lost us our train to Beas, we went to a supper provided by a satsangi railway official at the main Delhi station. He arranged sleeping accommodation for us. 27th December. This morning we continued our travels by train. We reached Beas soon after dark, where we were joyfully reunited with friends who came to meet us at the station, including Maharaji's wife Harjeet and Mrs. B. Jaunsey, one of our number who had preceded us to India earlier in the season. There was plenty of transport for all, a bus to carry the Indian satsangis, a lorry for all our baggage, and we brought up the rear in Maharaji's car. When we arrived at the Dera, Mohinder, who was a friend of the master's since childhood, organized a procession at the front entrance. We all went through the lamplit dusk, the Indians singing the Bainti hymn, through the main courtyard, where, feeling slightly lightheaded from the joy of my return combined with fatigue, the surroundings seemed like a vaguely remembered experience in another region, out through the further gates and under the archway into the master's beautiful garden. Footnote: The Bainti, a hymn of supplication by Swamiji Maharaj. End footnote. There it lay, his house, glowing with light at the end of the drive, down which we went singing more softly as we stood on its steps. We were welcomed inside and waited a short time in the lounge until he came and sat with us. Mohinder introduced us one by one, And Maharaji just sat there, quietly smiling and nodding, with an expression of ineffable love on his face. And we felt all the fatigue of the journey fall from us. 28th December. People are beginning to arrive for the Bhandara, and so Satsang, delivered in Punjabi, was held in the spacious courtyard of the Satsangar. One of the points Maharaji made was that when we are initiated, we are given two legs with which to walk to Satchkhand. The first leg is that of Simran, repetition. And when we have learnt to put that firmly forward, we then learn to use the other leg, which is Dhyan, contemplation. And with the use of these two, we can walk firmly onto the ladder of the sound current and climb to the ultimate heights of Satchkhand. On returning from Satsang, we were taken directly to have an audience, darshan, with the master in his garden. He asked about our flight and then said he felt ashamed he had not visited England to see us, rather than cause us to make the long journey out to India. But he had thought that as the Indians had not seen their families for a long time, it would be better for them to come home. Diwan Sahib Daryai Lal, standing behind the master, added very quietly, "And though it has been such a troublesome journey for you, yet if you consider, Maharaji has had to come down from Satchkhand to see you." Mr. Shidlow, an American satsangi, said he thought that if Maharaji were to visit England, many Americans would take the opportunity to come over to the United Kingdom to pay their respects. The master said, "We shall see." During the course of the afternoon, we were taken on a tour of the Langar, community kitchen, by Mr. Khanna, who was our mentor. While we were being shown the great cauldrons of cooking food, he told us a very moving story. On one occasion, some ingredient for prasad, blessed food, was in short supply, and the new stock had not arrived. The Sevadar in charge of that particular duty suggested that Maharaji should please consider giving out a little less than the customary handful to each person. Footnote. Sevadar, one who does seva or selfless service with no thought of material recompense. End footnote. When the distribution was made, Maharaji gave a double handful instead to each satsangi, and not only was there enough, but to spare for everyone. Maharaji then turned to the Sevadar and said, "Please forgive me. I hope I did not do wrong." On another occasion, he said to Mr. Khanna, "I am the servant of the Sangat. What they require of me, that I do." Mr. Khanna said that all he could do was to bow at his feet, overwhelmed by his humility. Tomorrow is the Bhandara, and 125,000 are expected. 80 buses and 400 tongas, horse-drawn cabs, as transport. Some of the people will have walked 200 miles to attend.